Masayoshi. Hi, good morning. Our industry has inconvenient truths. So the last 5 years, the number of smartphones has grown 37% CAGR. But some industry analysts said next 5 years, it's only going to grow 4%. That's sad. So the other point is that ARPU of our operators going down. It went down 47% in the last 10 years, but going down more. The other thing is that, however the ARPU is going down and the smartphones not increasing in the volume, the traffic of data is growing exponentially. So we have to do a lot of CapEx. So the operators, our industry, have a big headache. Lower ARPU, more traffic, more CapEx. What do we do? I didn't come here to talk about the sadness, the headache. Okay? It's a morning. We shouldn't get depressed too much. So I came here to talk about future. I came here to talk about my belief, next 30 years vision. So some of you may know that we just recently announced the SoftBank Vision Fund. That is $100 billion fund. This $100 billion is bigger than worldwide every venture capitalist added together. Worldwide venture capitalist volume of the capital is $65 billion. Worldwide, US, China, Japan, all over Europe, everybody added together $65 billion. SoftBank Vision Fund that I just recently announced is $100 billion. So just by ourselves, bigger than entire venture capitalists altogether. Just several months ago, I've announced acquisition of Arm. $32 billion I spent in cash. So why do I spend that much cash? Why do I aggregate that much cash to more to invest? Because I have a belief. I have a vision for the next 30 years. So let me ask, how many of you know the word, the meaning of singularity? So please raise your hand who knows the meaning of singularity. Okay, about half. Good. Only a couple of years ago, when I asked the same question, about 1%, 2%, depending on the audience, but only 1 or 2% people raise hand. Of course, the people here are smarter people, so if I ask the same question on the street, average people, how many percent do they know? Probably 2-3%. So this is the concept still not many people on the average understand yet or believe yet. I totally believe this concept, right? So for those of people who did not raise hand, please understand. This is the meaning that the day computer brain, the artificial intelligence surpass mankind brain. I think this will come in next 30 years. In next 30 years, this will become a reality. So when we talk about the brain power of human, mankind, typically, this is not the only way, but typically when we count the IQ, average people's IQ is 100. So if the genius like Einstein or Da Vinci, if you talk about their IQ, people say they are roughly 200. So anyway, if you have 200 IQ, you are called a genius. I don't know how many people here has 200 IQ. I don't. But anyway, 200 if you have genius, 100 average. Probably IQ on this room is a little bit better than 100. I hope. But anyway, what is the same measurement, IQ, 30 years later, the computer will have, one chip computer will have? I would say it will be 10,000. So what should we call? If the guy has 200 IQ, we call them genius. If a guy has 10,000 in IQ, what should we call? Super intelligence, okay? That is beyond our average people's imagination, how smart they are. But in 30 years, I believe this is going to become a reality. So what should we do? Anyway, when we count the power of our brain is consists of neurons. Neurons attach, disattach. It's a binary system. If it's attached or disattached, non-attached, zero or one. That's how our brain functions. That's how our neuron functions to memorize or think or calculate. So in the same kind of measurement, we have transistor in a chip. How many binary systems do we have? In mankind's main brain has about 30 billion cells, neurons. In transistors, when does the 30 billion binary system surpass it? I calculated about 20 years ago. I estimated about 20 years ago, and I said, should be year 2018. And just a few years ago, I recalculated, and again, it was year 2018. All right? If this year 2018 is few years wrong, I don't care. Right? 5 years earlier or later, it's just a margin of error. The point is, mankind for last 2,000 years, 4,000 years, had the same number of neurons in our brain. We didn't improve the hardware of our brain. But this, in next 30 years, is going to be 1 million times more. So when you have crossover of 30 billion chips in the transistors, does it get smarter than our brain or not? Of course, there is a software algorithm and so on, not just hardware-wise. But if you have a million times more binary system, I would say they will be smarter than us. Smarter than us. IQ 10,000. Okay? So, anyway, this burst of super intelligence is happening definitely, in my view, in the next 30 years. Big times crossing over. So this super intelligence built in, integrated into the robot, smart robot, okay? We have PCs, we have smartphones, they don't move. But if those super intelligence goes inside the moving device, robot, okay? Then the world, our lifestyle dramatically changes. I would say this automobile, they become a smart robot, in my definition. They would have a super intelligence and they move. In my definition, it's a smart robot, one of the kind. So there will be many kinds, flying smart robot, swimming, big, micro, run, many different shapes. Two legs, four legs, 100 legs. But anyway, the population of smart robot surpass mankind's population in next 30 years. That's my view, including these smart cars. The number of IoTs, it doesn't even take 30 years. As I said, I have just acquired ARM very recently. Just ARM alone will ship 1 trillion IoT chips in next 20 years. Doesn't even take 30 years. You know that 99% of our smartphone in our pocket is made by ARM chip. 99%, right? 80% of IoT chips will be ARM. So by knowing, by owning ARM, I can discuss with our engineers what will be the design next 10 years, right? So I have much better understanding than before our acquisition. So this 1 trillion chips is coming, and they will all get connected. So if I say number of subscribers does not grow, no, that's not true. The number of smartphones does not grow that much anymore. However, number of chips, the IoT chips, will grow to a trillion chips. So we will have a trillion subscribers. Somebody have to get, you know, connection. So we will have 1 trillion subscribers on the earth in the next 20 years. 1 trillion. That's not a small number. Okay? And they will all be smart, super intelligent. So think of this, one of the chip in our shoes, right? One of the chip in our shoes in the next 30 years will be smarter than our brain. Can you believe? We will be less than our shoes. And we are stepping on them, right? So anyway, it's an interesting society that comes. All those things will be interconnected. Not just the intelligence in the client level. Intelligence goes into the cloud. So we can share and manipulate real time. And that will all feed in to the artificial intelligence, super intelligence. And those goes to the autonomous driving, right? Automobile, right? Healthcare, consumer service, industrial, and so on. So that's why I have acquired ARM. So ARM, what is the two main focuses for enhancement? Since we acquired, I talk with our engineers every month, every week. And we are talking about security. We are talking about connectivity. Why security is so important? Because they would be hacked by bad guys. One of our group engineer had a waiting time for his wife in the lunchtime. So to kill his time, he did a little bit of a test. How many security camera can I hack before my wife comes in the lunchtime? He did it. In one lunchtime, he hacked 1.2 million security camera and said, wow, this was so easy to hack. So of course, he's not a bad guy, so he published the warning. This is how it is dangerous. This is how we should start thinking about protection of ourselves. The number of hacking is exponentially growing. We have to be very, very careful. So as I said, we are shipping a lot of ARM chips, but in the past, those were not secure. We are enhancing very quickly about the security. We need to secure all of the things in our society. So I have one example. Automobile. ARM, number of ARM chips in one car today, not future, today, in one car, there are 500 ARM chips for new car on the street today. 500 ARM chips. And none of them are secured today, by the way. I'm telling you because we are shipping it. Very, very dangerous. So one of our engineers did some tests, right? So look at this video.
I'll show you what happens. So we're stopped.
Yeah.
But now we're not stopped.
Oh man. I don't like that sound at all.
Yeah, I know. No cars break. Usually don't make that sound.
No, that's break. A scary sound.
All right, so you want to see like some steering and stuff?
Yeah, see some steering.
So, okay, so car get somewhere where we can go
stop the brake.
Okay.
So in reverse, not touch anything.
And hand off. Right? So this bad guy hacked.
That's that.
And
that
the car take crazy. Over the steering control. This is scary. Of course, our engineer is not the bad guy, so he's not going to do that. But there are a bunch of bad guys today, can hack. It's very scary. If I were a bad guy, this could be very, very, a dangerous way to attack the society. And so the car in the past were not connected into the internet. They were closed inside the car. But now many, almost every car manufacturer talking about connected car. Not just the autonomous driving, before autonomous driving, connected car. To diagnosis the car's maintenance system of the situation, they are dangerous. They get connected without security. So that's why we are putting a new security feature, not just in the sophisticated chip, but including all of the microcontroller chip. So all these devices have to be securely connected and encrypted into the cloud. So these will be connected and with a trust zone to all of the IoT devices. This is the new feature that we have just recently announced. Okay? Just last week we announced. So, and connectivity. The IoT chip will have a lot of connectivity features with a low power and a better performance. So this is the last week announcement of the narrowband IoT chip. Okay? With the security and high performance. So the chips on the parking lot can check the meter and connect to the crowd. So from the crowd, this operator from the center, they can understand how many cars are already full or vacant and so on. This technology will be shipped Q3 this year, and chip will be shipped next year. Okay? So this is another example to the home. All this will be connected securely and managed from the cloud. So all of the cities, all of the society's ecosystem infrastructure will be connected. On top of that, we just announced through the Software and Vision Fund, we would own the company called OneWeb. This is an exciting company. So as we are providing connectivity to the people, we've been using terrestrial towers and equipment. So to me, it's like arm. From the ground, we are connecting each other. Now, there is a like an Air Force or Space Force that's connecting to our society. In the past, the satellite was so far away, 36,000 kilometers, so far away. That's why there was a latency and slow in connectivity, narrow pipe. But we are introducing 1,200 kilometers. So that is 30 times closer to the Earth. Closer to the Earth. The distance is shorter. Therefore, the latency is much shorter. So there is a video here. So that's the Earth, and there is a geo satellite around the Earth, okay, shooting from so far away. Okay, that's today's satellite. This is today's satellite, geo station. But our new satellite is coming so much closer. Look, so many satellites We're gonna shoot 800 satellites in the next few years, and we're gonna increase to 2,000 satellites. From the space, those satellites become like a cell tower. If we have a terrestrial towers, okay, the signal is coming horizontally. So the signal hit the trees and the buildings and the roofs many, many times. And the speed and the performance get less and less. If you think of a fiber, fiber directly signal goes so straight without interference. Think of the fiber from the space coming to the Earth. Okay? No disturbance, straight from the space. And that will be connecting to our users. Right? So that, what will be the speed? 200 megabits down link and 50 megabit per second uplink. So that's the fiber kind of speed. Fiber kind of speed with fiber kind of latency. This will be provided. So that will be ubiquitously connecting all over, all kinds, including the rural areas and the rooftop, and of course, including the connected car. So the car goes to the suburban area or rural area. Today, our signal does not go. But tomorrow, with our satellite, the car connected, car will be connected all over the street or place where there is no street. So we are going to provide connectivity to billion subscribers from the satellite. Billion subscribers. So super intelligence is coming, and that super intelligence goes to the smart robot. Singularity is coming, as I said. I believe this concept, totally believe, no doubt, in next 30 years. So is singularity good or bad? They are so much smarter than us, so much capable than us, and they go into the smart robot and so on. What will be our job of mankind? What will be our life of our mankind? We have to ask philosophical questions, good or bad. So some scholars in University of Oxford has discussed and came up with 12 crises, the risks for the Earth, right? So those are a global pandemic, and artificial intelligence itself is a risk, nuclear war and super volcano and so on. So there are 12 kind of super crises that mankind may face. But artificial intelligence, one of those 12 crises can be a solution for the other crises, for the other 11 crises. So I think this super intelligence, artificial intelligence, is going to be our partner. Our partner. If we misuse it, it's a risk. If we use it in good spirit, it will be our partner for our better life. So the future can be better predicted, and people would live healthier, and so on. So I truly believe that this singularity is coming next 30 years. That's why I'm in a hurry to aggregate the cash, to invest, to bring the partners to connect for the society. Okay? 1 billion subscribers with 1 trillion IoT chips, with $100 billion investment. I'm looking for partners. Because we alone cannot do it. we have to do it quickly. And here, there are all kinds of candidates for my partner. I hope we will make it happen together for the goodness of humanity. Thank you very much.
So let me now introduce our next speaker, Dr. Wang from KT Corporation.